In Melbourne today, Ken Callender has penciled in some equines for your edification with a view to boosting your bank.
Thanks a lot, Bear. Well, here at Randwick, it's a pretty cold day, but horses are hardy animals and the track's in excellent condition. Unfortunately, down at Moonee Valley in Melbourne, there's been a bit of rain during the week and the track is slow. But don't worry about that. I've got a couple of mud runners for you in the legs of the Daly Double. In the first leg, I like number one, Balmoral Bow. Normally likes it a little bit longer, but he likes the wet and he'll rattle home. In the second leg, a special, number one, Val d'Azur. Up here in Sydney, pretty tricky races for the Double, but I like number three, King's Move, in the first leg, and number 11, Greaves, in the second leg. And of course, you'll see all of this racing action, both legs of both doubles in Sydney and Melbourne, here live on the wide world of sports. Thanks, Ian.
Glad you can. Thank you very much. Okay.
Yeah, thanks, Max. And the horse I've tipped's at big odds in the early market, but I think you'll see that he'll firm a little bit. And that's TAB number one, Balmoral Bow. He's at 10 to 1. 7 to 2 Green Sweeper, proud value at 10 to 1. 5 for Seal. Uncle Chuck is out. Joe, well in commission at 9 to 2 on the wet track. Scotch and Coke at 6 to 1. Snow Lord 11 to 2. 12 Blackbeard, 14 Regaldi, 50 South Prospect. Chadstone and Aviatic are not running. And the race is due to start in about 22 minutes' time.
Good on you there, Kenny. Okay, the team's title at the World Aerobic Championship usually goes to the outfit that can demonstrate perfect choreography.
Yeah, thanks, Maxie. It's about 2 minutes to post time. Time for us to go through an updated Victorian TAB market. Number one, Balmoral Bow, is in two. Oh, into about 7 to 1 now. Keeps on firming. I hope he can win. Green Sweeper at 4 to 1, crowd value at 8 to 1, Facile 11 to 2, Uncle Chuck is a scratching, Joe is a 9 to 2 chance, 7 to 1 Scotch and Coke, 13 to 2 Snow Lord, Blackbeard, Paddy Payne's mount, Paddy's already ridden a winner down there today, is at about 11 to 1. Regaldi, Kevin Forrester is at 14 to 1, and South Prospect is one of the roughies of the race, or actually the longest priced runner of all, at 40 to 1. Chadstone and Aviatic were both scratched this morning. The race is only 1,000 metres, so it's going to be a mad scamper. But there's number one, Balmoral Bow, there in the black and white stripes with the red cap. I expect him to settle back off the field a bit and then come with a wet sail at the finish. Hopefully that's the way the race will pan out, and if it does, well, I'll get the cash. Balmoral Bow's trained by John Maher, who's overseas at present, but he's had his most successful season with over 100 winners throughout Australia. I understand he went to the Derby in England, and he's looking at some likely prospects in Europe for perhaps the Melbourne Cup. Balmoral Bow is a five-year-old. He's won 9 races from 30 starts, and his form in the wet is even more impressive. I think it's something like about 4 out of 7. On slow tracks, which he's got today. TAB number two there, the grey, is Green Sweeper. Green Sweeper is ridden by Greg Hall, of course, who's won all the big races on the Australian turf. Balmoral Bow's jockey is the apprentice Brett Pebble. Pebble came to Sydney during the week and won a race on Dalharan. Now he's back home at Moonee Valley. Perhaps he can win another. I hope he does. Time for us now to cross to Melbourne. You can see the attendants with raincoats on. Here's our caller, John Russell.
All ready to go. Set for a start. Proud value lining up well. Waiting for the lights to go on. Stanwell Regaldi makes a good line. Set. Racing. Green Sweeper first to jump near the outside. Scotch and Coke began well with South Prospect and out fast. Blackbeard and Regaldi showing speed, and so is Fasciola. Proud Value was in behind them, and Balmoral Bow is last. Settling into Strider, and Regaldi moving up along the inside to tackle Green Sweeper. Fasciola just in behind them. Proud Value on the rails. They're followed by Joe and Blackbeard further back, followed by Balmoral Bow on the outside of Snow Lord and Scotch and Coca. And South Prospect is last of all. 500 metres out, Regaldi takes the leader. Half a length to Fasciola, a length away Joe. Green Sweeper, Proud Value getting a nice runner. Balmoral Bow is coming around them, then Scotch and Coke further back as Blackbeard, followed by Snow Lord and South Prospect as they make the home turner, where it's Fasciola moving up on the outside to tackle Regaldi, a length clear of Proud Value. Balmoral Bow as they straighten up, Regaldi tackled by Fasciola with 200 metres left to run. Proud Value is joining in and down the outside. Balmoral Bow, Regaldi still in front. Proud Value starting to flash down the outside. The three greys have it at the moment. Proud Value hits the front. Proud Value will win it. Proud Value first, second home Regaldi, third Balmoral Bow just ahead of Fasciola, a long gap to Joe, and further back Snow Lord, Scotch and Coke, South Prospect and Blackbeard, and the last home is Green Sweeper.
Still to come on Wide World of Sports, door-to-door racing in the old Dart as those 2-litre terrorists let loose in the British Touring Car Championships. There's $5,000 to be won in our memorable moments giveaway. You'll feel sorry for goalkeepers as this week's collection of World Cup goals hit the net. And we'll have you spilling your sides when funny man Billy Connolly tackles the round ball code. Australia's Sue Stanley trips the light fantastic at the World Aerobics Championships in the USA. We'll paddle back into the break on Jack McCoy's Indonesian surfing adventure. Let the horses loose down the quarter mile at Drag Racing's Winter Nationals. And see what tickled our fancy with the latest collection of plays of the week. Tonight and all week long, we'll be serving it up live from Wimbledon as we count down to finals week in the world's greatest tennis tournaments. Join Max Walker for the Sunday edition of Wide World of Sports when we experience all the splash and spills of a classic whitewater adventure on the Zambezi River and round up all the overnight results in the best of this sporting week. Then it's time to take an extra whiff of the smelling salts and dive into the rock with the gang on the Footy Show. Tomorrow afternoon, you can catch the white-knuckle drama as the field attempts to reel in Mick Doohan in the Dutch 500cc Grand Prix. Tomorrow on Sports Sunday, we catch up with the new million-dollar cricketer, Shane Warne. We look at the sport that's bowling maidens over and admire the talents of international diving star Michael Murphy. Our Rugby League Sunday night replay is the top-of-the-table clash between the North Sydney Bears and the Canterbury Bulldogs from Belmore. Baseball fans can set their alarms for the wee small hours of Monday morning for our Major League Game of the Week between the Phillies and Montreal. And on Tuesday morning, it's motor racing's turn with the Portland, Oregon round of the IndyCar Championship, dealing up the very best from home and abroad, including Wimbledon 94. This is the one and only Wide World of Sports.
Moonee Valley, race 5, 310 and 1, the numbers, Proud Value 730 and 260, Regaldi 350 and Balmoral Bow $2.60. Now let's go out to Kenny Callender for the latest on the next in Sydney. Ken.
Yeah, thanks, Bear. Balmoral Bow wasn't quite good enough. Let's hope I have a change of fortune here. Number 1, Red John at 7-1, Mr. Gooch at 8s. I'm on King's Move. He's 9-2 on the tote. Exposure at 16-1, Dorman Spile at 5-1. Double Exposure equal favourite at 9-2, Bayrami Lad at 40, B-Swift 15, Duquel 14, Hours After 16, 20 Molina, 40 Northern Emperor, 25 Pleasant Conquest, Single Seal at 66-1 and 100-1 The Shoe. The race in 15 minutes' time. Thanks, Ian.
Good on you, Ken. Thank you. In AFL, 4 matches in progress this afternoon. Let's see how things are going. Footscray.
1.5 minutes from post time. Pretty open race, this. A very hard one, in fact. Number 1, Red John. I think he'll have trouble running the distance. He's at 9-1. Mr. Gooch is also at 9-1. King's Move, he's firmed up. $4.60 on the tote, just over 7-2. Exposure, another distance risk, but a bit of value. Probably got a better chance, I think, than the top one. He's at 15-1. Dorman Smile, well, if he doesn't do something today, I don't think we'll be seeing him in town much longer. He's at 5-1. Double Exposure, we'll get back in the field and rattle home. TAB number 6, he's also out now to 5-1. Barami Ladders at 33-1. Number 8, B Swift, seems fair odds. 15-1. Jamie Innes, well drawn in barrier 3, should get a very, very good run. Duquel is at 12s into about 10s now. TAB number 10, Hours After, is keeps firming into about 8-1 and might come in another point or so yet, a little bit shorter with bookies. But he's got to produce on the day. He's at 8-1. Melina, 25s into 20s. Northern Emperor is at 33-1. Pleasant Conquest, TAB number 13, is at 25-1. Single Seal now out to 100-1. He'll need further. And The Shoe also needs further. He's at 100-1. They're milling around behind the barriers we see. That's TAB number 4, Exposure, there in the purple colours. Pleasant Conquest number 13 also going in. And number 12 there, Saddlecloth, is Northern Emperor. This is a 1,400 metre race. Pretty open field, as I said. Still the favourite, showing $4.80 now, just getting out of fraction, is King's Move. That was number 7, just went past us by Rami Ladd in the blue and white, Tony Cavallo. There's The Shoe there, one of the roughies. The Shoe needs about a mile and a half to show his best form, so I don't think he'll be getting in the way today over 1,400 metres. I think he's about the last to go in the line. The shoe, he's drawn the outside barrier. With John Tapp away on holidays, our caller today is Hilton Donaldson. The field.
Thanks, Ken. They're all in and set to go now for race number six, the Johnson & Johnson Medical Handicap over 1,400. Field of 15, exposures in this race and double exposure. We'll do our best with those two. Yeah, they're off and racing, a little bit slowly away, single seal. Duke Will missed the jump out wide and very slow to begin hours after. One of the best away, Red John, but instantly caught wide. Northern Emperor goes fast and takes the lead from it. Mr. Gooch gets along the rails to be one of the leaders. Then came B Swift, followed by Pleasant Conquest, Dorman Smile and Single Seal. A length away, Molina getting a check off heels. On its outside was King's Move, and out very wide on the track, Bayrami Lad, followed by Exposure. Then came Duke Will, further back hours after. Double Exposure is near the rear of the field. And last of all is the shoe. At the 800 metres they go, and the leader, Northern Emperor, about a half length in front of Red John, and one away third on the inside, Mr. Gooch, with the run of the race from B Swift. A half length away, Single Seal on the rails, Pleasant Conquest three wide around Dorman Smile. Then came Molina from King's Mood, Bayrami Lad very wide on the course. Hours after, needs an out, looking for a rails run. Exposure taking off wide from Du Quill, then Double Exposure and the shoe. 400 metres to go, and this roughie's running a bottling race in front. It's Northern Emperor about a length clear. Red John and Mr. Gooch comes home very strongly now. He gets the split and goes out after these leaders. Right down the outside, trying hard to make ground, King's Move, and then came B Swift. And hours after, in the middle, Mr. Gooch, Red John picking them up, Single Seal, Northern Emperor fighting back on the inside, Single Seal hit the front, Single Seal has gone to the lead, and Single Seal's won it by about a length and a half, very close to a dead heat for second. It might have been Northern Emperor on the inside, just ahead of Red John, and then Bayrami Lad flashing up late from Molina. Mr. Gooch didn't run on, followed by hours after. Then came Double Exposure, the shoe, Duke Will. Will back was B Swift, followed by Exposure, then Pleasant Conquest, and King's Move was last.
Well, the bookies are cheering in the streets, or cheering on their stands, because one of the 100-to-1 chances, Single Seal, has stormed down the outside. He's running fourth at the moment. That goes up to Red John, Mr. Gooch, and Northern Emperor over on the rails. And crash bang well up, home he goes to the tune of Paul Falvey's whip. And Single Seal, who'll pay over $100 for the win and $22 plus for the place, wins clearly from Northern Emperor. TAB number 12, I think, will get second over near the inside. Will pay $8 for second. And third, probably, I'd say, Red John has held on for third. TAB number one will pay $4.10. And flashing home for fourth was Bayrami Lad. They're not official, only the winner is. We'll have the official placings down the line. In the meantime, a break and then more on the wide world of sports.
Randwick race six, no dividends through at the moment because I suspect a Single Seal, number 14, paying such a big dividend. 14, 12 and 7, Single Seal, Northern Emperor, Bayrami Lad, pass the Monty a little later. Let's see how the footy's going.
Put myself together and, like I said, won. I had like 8 or 9 match points before I finally won it. So that was memorable.
When you chose to defect...
Thanks, Max. Yeah, punters are getting a bit of a pummeling here at Randwick. They've pinned their faith this time, as I have, in TAB number 11, Greaves. But here's a complete rundown of the prices for the second leg of the double. Paladin, well in commission, paying about 660 and 260, ran about 11 to 2. Skylock, been well supported in the ring, into 12 to 1, could come in another point or two. Might be one of the only leaders in this race too, Skylock. Pentas is at 9 to 1. Century Rain, well supported. Wayne Harris, already ridden the winner, at $5.90, almost 5 to 1. Demerit, one of the roughies, one of the strong Ingham Brothers team, is at 33 to 1. Double Take is at 8 to 1 from New Zealand, getting out now to 9 to 1. Golden Step at 14 to 1. Number 8, Sungent at 10 to 1. 33, Tullerone. Jenkins, Kevin Moses' mount, trained by Bart Cummings, goes best in longer races, and Jenkins is at 20 to 1. Now, number 11 is Greaves, the favourite, paying $3.40 for a dollar investment on the tote, not quite 5 to 2. Greaves races today in black with a white star and a white cap, the second set of the Ingham Brothers colours, with TAB number 5, Demerit, the roughie, wearing the All Cerise. So if you're looking for the favourite, he's got black with a white star, or a white Maltese cross, I think it is, and a white cap. There he is there, black with a white star and a white cap. He's TAB number 11. The bottom two in the market, Sir Craig, is at 100 to 1, and Falcon Walk, to be ridden by Paul Falvey, who's already ridden the double here at Randwick today, is at 40 to 1. And there's Greaves going in. Michael Evans, the rider, apprentice to John Hawkes at Warwick Farm. And John, of course, trains Greaves. Now, there's the stablemate in the Cerise colours, Demerit. He's a roughie, Demerit. A young Dean Tant, he's got the ride on him, and he's at 33-1. Okay, they're just about all in. There's Skylock going into line now. As I said, he can be expected to lead in the race or be up there near the lead. Mark Lynch, a very strong jockey, is in the saddle on Skylock, a horse who's got a mind of his own, but Lynch seems to ride him best and won recently on an out-of-town track on him. Okay, they're all in. Here's our caller, Hilton Donaldson.
And they're ready to run now for race 7, the 2UE Welter Handicap. Starters at the platform, 1600 the journey, brilliant sunshine in Sydney again today. Trifecta not going off in the previous. Paid on second from first, away they go. Slow to begin from the inside, Falcon Walk and Sir Craig immediately out the back and going over towards the rails. Showing speed out very wide on the track, Skylock. Caught wide, the rider obliged to send the horse forward in a fast motion and goes to the lead by a length and a half, now two on Golden Step. Third placing, Double Take, followed by Greaves getting into the action nicely. It's running fourth, about three off the lead. Back on the inside in next placing came Tullerone, followed by Jenkins and then Pentas. Out very wide on the track next was Paladin. It's off the course from Demerit. Back on the rails, Falcon Walk, well back Century Rain. In company with it was Sun Genton. Last of all, and a length and a half off them is Sir Craig. Approaching the 800-metre mark, and the leader is going boldly, Skylock, by two lengths. Double Take is racing second on the outside of Golden Step. Now moving up three wide, Tullerone, and also following it around the outside, it was Greaves. Further back in the field, Jenkins. Falcon Walk getting inside runners from Pentas. Well out of its ground, coming to the turn, Century Rain, Sir Craig. And back with those also was Falcon Walk, and Peloton's wide about fourth last on the turn, 4:50 to go, and it's Skylock going strongly, two lengths in front of Golden Step, who's had the track up all the way and pulls to the outside. Here comes Greaves out wide with Pentas, and Peloton down the centre of the track running on. They've got to get to this leader, Skylock. Greaves quickly though got onside. Greaves goes to the lead from Skylock. On the outside, Pentas is chasing Greaves, then Golden Step, Falcon Walk, and fighting back on the rail, Skylock, but Greaves is in front close to home, and this flashy looking customer, Greaves, is going to win by a length. Second Golden Step, a head away third out wide Pentas, and fourth over on the rail Skylock, then Double Take, Falcon Walk, Sun Gent, followed further back by Century Rain, Demerit, then Jenkins, Tullerone, Paladin raced wide, ran near the rear with Sir Craig, who was pretty much last all the way.
Yeah, well, one for the bookies there. TAB number 11 Greaves firmed up late on the tote, and a little bit disappointing the price, but he's won. That's what counts. $3.10 the win and $1.70 the place. There he goes to the lead from the early fair leader, Skylock, over on the rails in the green. In the centre, in the red and yellow colours, is Golden Step. Golden Step has just hung on for second, number seven, and he'll pay $3.80 for the place. And Pentas, number three, was third, ridden by Rodney Quinn, and Pentas will pay $2.70 the place, with Skylock will be officially fourth. That was the story of the second leg of the Daly Double in Sydney. A break, and then we'll be back with the second leg of the Daly Double at Moonee Valley.
On 7. And the numbers were 11, 7 and 3. Greaves, $3.10 and $1.70. Golden Step, $3.80. And Pentas, $2.70. Four matches in AFL. Kenny Callender is ready. Oh, sorry, Ken.
The other Ken Bear, but I've just got you a bit of money on Greaves. I've got to put the lot here. I didn't even bother collecting it. I just said to the bookie, put the lot straight in on Valdezaire. I need two winners in a row, only 6-4. Danny Beasley riding him. I think he'll get the prize. Turnout is at 7-1. Hazem at 8-1. Eddie Kazar riding him. Moreland Strike at 30-1. On Kylie's Run, used to race here in Sydney. Doesn't mind it a little bit wet, should run a bit of a race at his odds of 16-1. Simple as that. Well, racing game isn't quite that. Damien Oliver, the rider, a good chance, simple as that. Probably the main danger to the favourite. He's at 11-2. Swift Talent is a scratching. Accommodate, Craigd In at 16-1. High Waters, Sally Wynn, very good lady jockey or apprentice, at 10-1. Peg's Gift, Jason Patton, at 11-1. Mentat's Rule is a scratching. Regal Rourke is at 33-1. And then a couple more roughies. Caledonian Image at 60-1. Kimberlite at 50-1. Montenegro is a scratching. And Chilmac is a 100-1 chance. Valdezar, a clear-cut favourite in the second leg at Moonee Valley. And, yep, raincoats are still on there. It's been a pretty rotten day down at Melbourne. Let's hope that punters cheer here with Valdezar winning. Here's our caller, John Russell.
Ready the rough now. And Regal Rourke was the first into stride near the inside from Hazem, and Chilmac began well with Accommodate behind them, and Turnout was well away. And High Waters is going fast, followed by On Coily's Run, and just in behind them, Valdezir, simple as that, further back in the field, followed by Caledonian Image, and they were followed then by Peg's Gift, and further back towards the tail there is Kimberlite, and Meridian Strike has dropped out to last. Around the first turner, 1,200 metres out, Hazem showing the way, taken on by High Waters. A length and a half, Chilmac on the outside of Regal Rourke, On Coily's Run, and Turnout in behind them, Accommodate the rails from Valdezir. Peg's Gift is next on the inside of Simple as That, a length and a half, Caledonian Image on the outside there of Kimberlite, who's next to last, and last of all, Meridian Strike, about 10 lengths off the lead, down the cider, and High Waters has taken up the running at the 8.50, led by a length to Hazem, half a length to Chilmac, over on the outside on Kylie's Runner, back on the rails, Regal Rourke, followed by Turnout, Valdezir, pulled to the outsider, further back in the field, then Simple as That, followed by Accommodate from Peg's Gift, and Caledonian Image is very wider, and then Kimberlite, second last, and last of all, Meridian Strike, up past the 600 metre mark, they travel, and Hazem again has moved up to put his head in front here of High Waters, a length and a half Turnout, and Simple as That making ground rapidly, and Valdezir was also putting himself in the picture, being followed by On Coily's Runner, dropping out of it, Regal Rourke, Accommodate back behind them, Hazem is the leader, Simple as That is about five off the fence, coming at Hazem, and they're clear from Valdezir, Turnout, and High Waters over on the inside as they straighten up, Simple as That hit the front and kick clear of Hazem, in third place under pressure, Valdezir followed by High Waters, but Simple as That is clear in the run home, and Simple as That is too good, and is drawing away for a very easy victory, Simple as That he's down on the post to score, one by two lengths to Hazem with Valdezir third, then High Waters, Accommodate, Turnout, behind them Caledonian Image, and the next to finish on Kylie's Run, further back in the field then Kimberlite, followed by Meridian Strike, well back with Chilmac, followed by Regal Rourke, and last home Peg's Gift.
Coming up on Wide World of Sports, those tin tops take it to the absolute limit in the latest round of the British Touring Car Championship. We'll give you one more bash of the cash in our $5,000 Memorable Moments giveaway. From the tropical reefs of Indonesia, we'll look through the lens of Jack McCoy's cameras for more surfing perfection. Sue Stanley hits centre stage in search of gold at the World Aerobics Championships. And we'll touch down in sports hotspots to round up all those plays of the week. Tonight and all week long, we'll be serving it up live from Wimbledon as we count down to finals week in the world's greatest tennis tournament. Join Max Walker for the Sunday edition of Wide World of Sports when we experience all the splash and spills of a classic whitewater adventure on the Zambezi River and round up all the overnight results in the best of this sporting week. Then it's time to take an extra whiff of the smelling salts and dive into the rock with the gang on the Footy Show. Tomorrow afternoon, you can catch the white-knuckle drama as the field attempts to reel in Mick Doohan in the Dutch 500cc Grand Prix. Tomorrow on Sports Sunday, we catch up with the new million-dollar cricketer, Shane Warne. We look at the sport that's bowling maidens over and admire the talents of international diving star Michael Murphy. Our Rugby League Sunday night replay is the top-of-the-table clash between the North Sydney Bears and the Canterbury Bulldogs from Belmore. Baseball fans can set their alarms for the wee small hours of Monday morning for our Major League Game of the Week between the Phillies and Montreal. And on Tuesday morning, it's motor racing's turn with the Portland, Oregon round of the IndyCar Championship, dealing up the very best from home and abroad, including Wimbledon 94. This is the one and only Wide World of Sports.
And the numbers were 6, 3, and 1, simple as that, 6, 40, and 2, 10. Hazem, $2.40, and Valdezir, $1.60. Those AFL games, four of them.
The 10, the trifecta, 160-130. 160-130 and the running double, $44.40.
Sweep of the favourite out the outside gate with Balmoral Bow. Just waiting on the light. Lights on. Racing. Green Sweeper out quickly with Scotch and Coke out wide. They bounce quickly. Away fast, Blackbeard in the centre and Regaldi over on the inside from Proud Value. Last Bell, Marlborough. Green Sweeper out deep, Regaldi and Blackbeard. And Facile going forward with Proud Value. Joe just behind them. Two further back, Snow Lord around at Bell, Marlborough from Scotch and Coke. And last of all, South Prospect through the gap at the 600 metre mark. Regaldi a half Facile. Joe has gone up third. Green Sweeper is fourth and wide from Proud Value. A length further back in the race then came Bell, Marlborough, Scotch and Coke. Further back then, Snow Lord the inside up to the bend. And it's Regaldi and Facile, two in front of Proud Value. Balmoral Bow to the outside, followed by Joey's under pressure. On the bend they race now, Regaldi outside at Facile. Proud Value further out from Balmoral Bow. Facile, Regaldi and Proud Value. Three greys now, two in front of Balmoral Bow. It's Regaldi and Proud Value out wide from Facile and Balmoral Bow. Regaldi and Proud Value fighting it out. Proud Value going home better. And Proud Value three quarters, Regaldi. Balmoral Bow grab third from Facile. Then a gap, Joe, Snow Lord, Scotch and Coke. Further back in the race then came South Prospect, Blackbeard, and Greensweeper not going at all well at the moment, has run last.
Three Proud Values, 770, 250, 10 Regaldi, 310, 1 Balmoral Bow, 260.
On the Super Tab there, number three, Proud Value, to return 365 the win, 130 the place, number 10, Regaldi, a place dividend of 175, 1 Balmoral Bow, $1.30. 1 minute dead, the time, 1 minute dead.
Second place in going to Regaldi, and the judge asking for the print here for third. Balmoral Bow on the outside and Facile in this photo for third placing, with Balmoral Bow getting the stride in. You'll find again third prize right on the line.
With Northern Emperor racing in blinkers today. Bayrami Lad and the Shoe are the others away from the stalls, but generally they're coming in as a very well-behaved lot of gallopers. And the Shoe from the Les Bridge stable, number 15 in the stall. Number 15 will complete the line. Mr. Gooch drawn on the inside. Corey Brown up. He's only had the one run back. Nice effort here. Now, up to line goes the Shoe, and everything is in readiness.
Rick White Adelaide.
Two of the clerks of the course come round the front to check the action. Everything's right. They join the third clerk alongside the stalls. Which open, and there they go. And Red John was first to break. Kings move out well, and so too looking for the lead. Northern Emperor, Mr. Gooch is handy, and the same can be said for B. Swift. Pleasant Conquest getting back a little with Kings move now, then Dorman Smile single sealed by Rami Led, followed by Molina, a length to Duke Quell, and then come Exposure and Double Exposure hours after next to last, and the Shoe brings up the rear. Onto the course proper they travel, and Northern Emperor in his blinkers fired up, leads a length Red John, third Mr. Gooch, B. Swift is travelling fourth, followed by Single Seal, Pleasant Conquest, Dorman Smile, and then a break to Molina, followed on the extreme outside next by Rami Lad. Kings moves between horses. Hours after on the inside of Duquel, and then comes Exposure. Two to Double Exposure and ahead the inside. The Shoe, 600 to go. No great change in the order. And Northern Emperor nearly two lengths. Red John a length to Mr. Gooch. Two further back is old Single Seal inside. B. Swift and a length into Dorman Smile, followed by Pleasant Conquest, and further away is Molina in the stretch on top of the rise. 350 to go. Northern Emperor tackled by Red John. Mr. Gooch comes between them. Two lengths to Single Seal, and then comes B. Swift. 200 to go. Northern Emperor the leader from Mr. Gooch. Red John and then Single Seal. It's Northern Emperor still in front. Red John, Mr. Gooch, and oh, Single Seal. Single Seal will blow them all away. And down to the line goes Single Seal to win. There are three in it for miners. Red John, the fast finishing Bayrami Lad, and Northern Emperor, followed by ours after Mr. Gooch, and then a gap, Molina, Double Exposure, and the Shoe. Further away then, Duquel, B. Swift, Dorman Smile, Exposure, and the last two, Pleasant Conquest and King's Move.
On the Super Tab, number 14, Single Seal, $57.45 for the win, $13.05 the place. Miners, one Red John, $2.15. Number seven, Bayrami Lad, $5.05, or 12, Northern Emperor, $4.15.
11th at Newcastle and an open handicap. Behind Burrendar Boy at his last run, but two starts ago he'd run second at Tamworth. Three starts ago he'd run 10th at Tamworth. But by the same token, three starts ago was back in November of 1992. He's only had two runs since 1992. Number 14, the winner, single seal, Paul Falvey. And on the New South Wales tote, number 14 has paid in excess of $100. We can't give you the official breakdown at the moment, but in excess of $100, $22 the place. Now, there are three in it for the minor placings. On a hectic day of finishes here at Randwick, Red John, working from the top, was $4.10 by